Hallelujah.
So much. I want to welcome everybody to the line. I've known Minister Pastor Bihiri for such a long time. We remember way back in Minnesota when we met. Man, he's always had the same passion. And the grace on his life has grown. I've watched him over the years. He's doing mighty, mighty things for God. And it's such an honor to be here today. I want to thank you, man of God. Thank you so much, Pastor. I do not take it lightly. Everyone, I just want you to know, I want you to say shout hallelujah.
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 Hallelujah. This is your morning. I want to, one of the things I want to do today, I just told Mr. Barry 30 minutes. I'm just going to speak for 15, and I'm going to leave you in prayer for 15. But I know that after our moment together, your life will never be the same. I did not come this morning on my own accord. I came from God. Because your money, your life is about to be changed forever in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Yesterday I was with Apostle Charles in the phone. Apostle Charles in the phone has had the opportunity to travel over 85 countries, miracles from around the world. And the reason he came to Houston yesterday was there was a man that was in a coma for 3 weeks. The problem sometimes with Christians is we are so interested in activity instead of productivity. We're busy, we're so busy. We want to pray when we should be commanding. We want to fast when we should be speaking to the devil. The Bible says, "These signs will follow them that believe. In my name, they will cast out devils." We want to delegate and negotiate with devils when we should be commanding them to move. So this man had been in the coma for 3 weeks. And I told my wife, I said, tell the family to call apostle. There are times you need specialists in the kingdom. When you're fighting the battles that you need help, call someone who's good at that. And that's why when you connect to a man of God, a pastor like Pastor Bihiri, you're connecting to someone who's a specialist in handling situations. And so sometimes you need to get those specialists in your life. And so we called Apostle Charles, and the doctors are told, said, this man is done. This week they were going to unplug him from all the machines that he was on. Apostle came, when he landed 2 days ago, he told the family, listen, I didn't come here to pray. You prayed, God answered. And when God answered, God sent me. Because whenever you pray, do you know what God does? The Bible says the children of Israel prayed. And what did God do? He sent a man, Moses. When the children of Israel prayed, he sent judges to Israel. So whenever you pray, God sends a man or woman of God. And when that man or woman of God comes, do you know what they come to do? They come to speak a word. Because the Bible says where the word of a king is, there is power. So that's what we've come to do this morning. And I've come to activate many of you. I've come to tell you that there is a king in you. I've come to tell you that you're not ordinary. You're sent from God to bless your world. Many of you, by the time we're done this morning, some of you are just going to realize that, hey, I'm anointed too to do mighty works. And so let's go back to, because Pastor Bihiri is telling me you guys are focusing on the book of Esther. And so last, when he told me about Esther, I studied Esther, and I came up with all these powerful points about Esther's, from Esther's perspective about prayer and about fasting. And after yesterday, I realized, because when Apostle walked into the room with this unconscious man for 3 weeks, Apostle didn't even pray. He just told the man, he says, get up now. And instantly, life came back to that man. And the man that was not responding for 3 weeks began to talk, began to respond. I mean, everyone was in awe. The family was shocked. They'd been praying for this man for weeks. Nothing was happening. But when a man of God spoke a word, something changed. And that's what I want to focus on. I want us to turn our Bibles, if you have your Bibles, to Esther chapter 4, verse 11. Esther chapter 4, verse 10 and 11. Are you there? Hello? Can you hear me? Oh, you guys, okay, awesome. So Esther chapter 4, verse 10. He says, again, Esther spake unto Tarshish and gave him commandments unto Mordecai. Verse 11. All the king's servants and the people of the king's province do know that whosoever, whether man or woman, shall come unto the king into the inner court, who is not called, there is one law of him, of his, to put him to death. Except such to whom the king shall hold out the golden scepter, that he may live. I have not been called to come in unto the king these 30 days. So here's the situation. Esther, Mordecai, the children of Israel were condemned to die. They were going to die. And so Mordecai puts on sackcloth and he just was in mourning and in prayer. And when Esther heard about it, because anyone who was not dressed appropriately could not come into the king's presence. So he could not enter the king's palace. He had to stay outside the king's quarters. And so when Esther heard about it, she sent her servant to find out what was going on with her uncle. And when they got to her uncle, the uncle told the servant what was going on. And when Esther heard it, the uncle was telling Esther, I want you to go to the king and speak on behalf of the Jews so that the king can free us. The king can stop the decrees of Haman. And Esther said something. Hey, listen, uncle, there's a little problem here. There is everyone in the king's kingdom knows that nothing can come within a radius of the king. If you enter the king's presence without the right authorization, you die on contact. And then it dawned on me. Sometimes we don't understand the three things I want us to draw from here. We know your kings in life. The Bible says in Revelation chapter 1, verse 5 and 6, because I want you to understand something. Because many times when we look at this verse, we look at it from Esther's perspective. But now I want you to look at it from a different perspective. The Bible says one thing about us, that God has made us kings and priests. Do you know you're a king in life? What do kings do? Kings reign over situations. Kings reign over problems. Kings reign over sickness. It's time for you to step into your place. In Revelation chapter 1, verse 4, Revelation chapter 1, verse 5, he says, and from Jesus Christ, who is the faithful witness and the first begotten of the dead and the prince of the kings of the earth, unto him that loved us. Oh, God loves you. He loves us so much. Unto him that loved us and washed us from our sins. He's not about to do it. He already done it. He's already washed us from our sins with his own blood. I like the next verse. He says, and had made us kings. Did you see that? He's made us kings and priests unto God and his Father. What does a king do? A king reigns. Do you know that they could not kill Jesus before his time? There was a time they walked him right to the edge of the cliff to throw him off a building, and they could not do it. The Bible says he turned around and walked away from the midst of them. There's so many of you who are scared and tormented by demons at night. It's time to arise and say, no more, devil, no more. Look at what the Bible says about King Ahasuerus. Esther said, nobody can come into the king's presence without his authorization. That's who we are. That's who we are in God. Nothing can come into our presence. Esther said, he says, there is a law. There is one law of him to put him to death, except such to whom the king shall hold out the golden scepter. How many things have you permitted in your life? And you were thinking, oh, you know, do you know that, I'll say this, when Jesus told Peter to walk on the water, did you realize that Peter began to sink after he started walking? That immediately Jesus held Peter and raised him up. Why? Because in the presence of Jesus, Peter would have died. There are many Christians around the world, they're dying in the presence of God. They've been fasting and praying and nothing is happening because they refuse to command their mourning. I remember a story about Kenny Hagin. He said he kept praying for his son. His son was 15 years old, and I'm praying for God to heal his son. And God says, I'm not about to heal him anymore. Tell him to pray. He has his own mouth. And Kenny Hagin turned to his son and said, hey, you got to pray. And when his son prayed, God healed his son immediately. Why? Because there comes a time when you need to grow up and step into the authority that God has given you. The second thing I want us to draw from Esther chapter 4, verse 11, he says, the king, he says, and all the king's servants and the people of the king's province do know that what whosoever, whether man or woman, shall come in unto the king, into the inner court, who is not called, there is one law of his to put him to death. The second thing I want us to draw from that is set up the law for your life. You're a king. What's the law? What's operational in your airspace? Do you know that you cannot fly into the airspace of the United States without being shut down? If you, right now, if you want to fly into Washington, D.C., you need to have a secret code. If you fly into the airspace of Washington, D.C., F-16s will shoot you down instantly. Oh, la proskantali gonskataya. Who's been flying in your airspace? I remember a story about Donkey Williams. He was telling, he said, one day he lifted his hands and said, every power in the air, I shut down this airspace. And the next morning when they woke up, witches were dying, were on the ground dead. He shut down the airspace over his life. It's time to set up the airspace and the arena over your life. How do you do that? The Bible says in Job 22, verse 28, thou shalt also decree a thing, and it will be established. Have you decreed anything in your life lately? Have you said, devil, this far and no more? Sickness, this far and no more? There's a lady with a heart condition. God just healed you now. I command your heart to be healed completely. There's someone with a migraine headache. God's healing that migraine headache. It will never return. There's someone with a demonic oppression. God's delivering you right now. Speak life into you. I command those demonic activities to cease in your life in the name of Jesus. It's time to command your mourning as a king. Stop letting the devil walk all over you. There's a time to pray. Priests serve the glory, but kings coming with the glory. That's why Jesus says, you are the light of the world. You're the salt of the earth. What does light do? Light lights up the area. When the light comes, the Bible says the darkness cannot comprehend it. It's time to arise and shine on your job. And the last thing we need to learn from that, the third point I want us to learn is learn how to use the golden scepter. The Bible says, he says, I'll go back again to Esther chapter 4. He says, all the king's servants and the people of the king's province do know that whosoever, whether man or woman, shall come unto the king into the inner court, who is not called, there is one law of his to put him to death, except to whom the king shall hold out the golden scepter that he may live. Learn to use the golden scepter. Now, you know what the Bible says in Galatians chapter 4, verse 1 to 3? I have three more minutes, and then we'll go into prayer. In Galatians chapter 4, because although you're called to be a king in life, although God has called you and made you kings, the Bible says in Galatians chapter 4, now I say that the heir, as long as he's a child, differeth nothing from his servant, though he be lord of all, but is under tutors and governors unto the time appointed of the father. Even so, when we were children, we're in bondage under the elements of the world. Paul the Apostle says, when we were kids, we were in bondage. Because it doesn't matter how long you've been in church. The Bible says, my people are destroyed for lack of knowledge. You know one thing I've discovered in the body of Christ? We love activities. We love to pray. But you will never sit down to get knowledge. You need to sit down and get knowledge. You need to learn what is this life that was given to me in Jesus. What do you know your rights in Christ? Do you know what you've been given in Christ? The Bible says he's made us to sit in heavenly places with Christ Jesus, far removed from principalities and powers. Do you understand that? Do you know that? Three things we learned from Esther chapter 4. Verse 11, number one, recognize that you're a king. Number two, set up the law of your life. In Psalm chapter 27, he says they will come up against me. He says one thing in Psalm 27 verse 4. I'll read this and then we're about to pray. Hallelujah. He says Psalm 27 verse 2. He says, when the wicked, even my enemies and my foes, came upon me to eat up my flesh, they stumbled and fell. So set up the law of your life. And number three, learn to use your golden scepter. Get the book. Get back into the Bible. Study the word. Listen to Pastor Behiri's messages. Go back. Listen to Pastor Esther. Listen to these messages that are coming to you and study. Hallelujah. Glory to God. How many of you were blessed by this? Hello.
Amen.
Amen.
Always remember, you are king. Number two, set up the laws of your life. Do not leave it to chances. And number three, learn how to use your golden scepter. So now we're going to pray. We're going to take three prayer points. Are you ready to pray?
Yes.
Are you ready to pray?
Yes.
Ephesians chapter 1, verse 17. The Bible says in Ephesians chapter 1, that's where our first prayer point is taken from, Ephesians 1:17. He says that the God of our Lord Jesus Christ, the Father of glory, may give unto you the spirit of wisdom and revelation in the knowledge of him. I want you to say, my Father, my Maker. Say it with some boldness, my Father, my Maker. The spirit of wisdom, say, my Father, my Maker.
My Father, my Maker.
Please give me the spirit of wisdom and revelation.
Please give me the spirit of wisdom and revelation.
In the knowledge of you.
In the knowledge of
you. Open your mouth and begin to pray.
My Father, my Maker. Please give me the spirit of revelation. I want you to say, shout it loud, amen.
Amen.
Listen, you know what the Bible says? It says, my people are destroyed, not for lack of power, not for lack of anointing, but for lack of knowledge. I want you to pray. A part B of that prayer is, Lord, open my eyes that I might behold wondrous things from your word. When your eyes of your understanding is open, you will begin to move in dimensions of the spirit. I want you to say, my Father, my Maker.
My Father, my Maker.
Open my eyes to behold.
Open my eyes to behold.
wondrous things out of your word. Open your mouth and pray. Our next prayer point comes from Isaiah 54, verse 17. Uh-huh. No weapon. Hey, Rabashata Kaboski. No weapon that's formed. No weapon that is formed against thee shall prosper. Every tongue that shall rise against thee on your job, every tongue that shall rise against thee, he says, against thee in judgment, thou, not God, thou shall condemn. Unto you decree a thing, it will not be established unto you. So our second prayer point is we're going to set up the law of our lives. We're going, hey, there's someone here. I see pain that shoots down through your hip. God's healing you completely. That pain is gone, will never return. I pray this has just been healed. I give you praise. Hallelujah. There's some hallucosing too. When we were praying earlier, I saw palpitations of the heart. God is healing you. That irregular heartbeat is stopping right now. It will never return in the name of Jesus. I want you to say, my Father, my Maker. Say, my Father, my Maker. I hear you. Say, my Father, my Maker. Hello?
Hallelujah. Every weapon.
Jesus' name, we pray. I have 4 more minutes. 4 more minutes. Something is happening in the realms of the spirit. I see a lady here. There's a lady. You've been having tormenting thoughts. You can't tell anyone, and the thoughts have been telling you are no good. You are not qualified. You are not worthy, and those thoughts have caused you to just be frustrated. But those thoughts end tonight, this morning, in the name of Jesus. I command those tormenting thoughts to cease completely in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Back pain has just been healed. Someone with a back pain, the back pain just left your body completely right now. I give you praise. I give you praise. There's a ringing in the ears that's just stopped right now. Someone has ringing in the ears. It's stopped right now. Lastly, I want to... Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Hallelujah. Mansoka parilo ho santara bakaraboski. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. There's something, I mean, when we began to pray just moments ago, speak, destinies began to move. Destinies began to change. Destinies began to change. I have 2 more minutes. I want us to pray this last prayer. And hallelujah. I want us to say this because the Bible says, everyone that came before, in fact, do you know why Esther and all those people had to go to the fast? Because no one could come to the presence of the king. And if they came without authorization, they died by fire. Hey, when Haman, when the king came back, when the king was angry and he looked at Haman, all the king had to do was just say a word. Are you going to sleep with my wife also? And they took Haman and killed him. Hey, I'm a king in life. Say, I'm a king in life.
I'm a king in life.
Hey, say, I reign over situations.
I reign over situations.
I'm not a victim of situations. I reign over them.
I am not a victim of situations. I reign over them.
This is the last prayer. prayer I want us to pray. Say, every troubler of my destiny. What are you waiting for?
What are you waiting for?
Fire!
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 I just want to pray a blessing over you, because while we're praying just moments ago, God began to say, I should tell you, it's a new season.
Amen.
Things, your the seasons of your life has changed.
Amen.
Jesus. Hallelujah.
Father, in the name of Jesus,
you,
I bless
Jesus.
Your people with your presence.
Thank you, Lord.
Amen. I bless your
Thank
people
you,
with your unction.
Thank you, Jesus.
I really bless your people with your power. Prosper in all they do. From this moment, your anointing to prosper upon them, O God.
Yes.
In the name of Jesus.
Lord, yes.
Business ideas.
Yes.
Business ideas.
Yes.
I come against the fear, the fear that's holding them down. Loose them now from
there.
In the name of Jesus.
Jesus.
God is increasing you mightily. I see dreams that God had given to you. Dreams that, in fact, you've not been able to tell people. You've written them down in journals. And you've been waiting for the right time, but God says this is the moment. Those dreams, you can bring them back out. They shall come to pass. In the name of Jesus, the orphanages shall be filled. The orphanages shall be filled. Those orphanages spread about. They shall be filled. Says God's prophet is blessed. It's your season. It's your moment. It's your time. For the spotlight of and this moment is a moment. This is your year of acceleration and speed, says God, in the name of Jesus. Everyone else on the line, oh God, God is saying to everyone else, a new season has been gone. And Lord, we decree this is the moment in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father, because it's done. And I pray that everyone else, that every kind of healing that everyone else needs, I pray healing and restoration to marriages in the name of Jesus. Healing and restoration to hearts. I see broken hearts in this, people who have broken hearts. I pray those hearts be mended right now. And I pray the peace of God that passes all understanding guard your heart right now in the name of Jesus. Amen. Man of God, please, Pastor Beery, thank you so much. Please, over back to you.
Yes,
sir.
If you were during the course of the prayer, you were giving a particular word as a prophetic word. And I think it was a little bit interrupted. It was not clearly heard because everybody was speaking. So I had to mute it, you know. So I don't know if there's any way you can repeat what you were saying. Is it possible?
You remember which you mean right moments ago or?
Yeah, moments ago. Just moments ago. You were prophesying to two individuals and you're also prophesying to everybody.
That's right. For Prophet's blessing, when we were praying earlier, I was seeing in the realms of the spirit that she had dreams she had written down in a journal, and if she's here, she can confirm this. And I see she was writing these dreams in a journal, and these are things that she had not even told anyone. They look so big, and I could also see orphanages that she has a heart to help kids, and just to build orphanages. And God is saying those dreams are coming to pass, and there's no need to be afraid that, because God also said this is your year of speed and acceleration. Also, what I was also seeing for everyone, that God was saying this is a new season, because when we prayed the second prayer point, I just saw that things were being shifted and moved in people's lives. Because when you step into your office as a king, things begin to happen. King Hazazarus, no one could come into his presence except he gave them authorization. And what God began to do in this prayer point was began to position people's mindsets. There were a lot of people, I saw a lot of people that were just operating from the position of fear. And God's saying, there's no need to be afraid anymore. There's no need to be afraid. Because I even saw someone that's seeking for promotion on the job. They are wondering, is this going to happen? God says, go for the promotion. It shall come to pass. Thank you, man of God.
Hallelujah. Blessings. How many of you receive him? How many of you thank God for him? Hallelujah. What a God we serve. Amen.
Yeah.
Somebody shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Lift your voices and begin to speak to the Lord, that the Lord will multiply grace upon him. Amen. Let's ask the Lord that the Lord will anoint you with more grace.
Amen.
Open your heart and begin to pray.
My Father, the Balaba, the Shabbat, the
I told you all that you guys will be blessed.
Yes.
Hallelujah. And how many of you know that your time has come? Let me tell you something. Before this Esther fast comes to an end, two sisters receive a surprise blessing. A surprise blessing. Even as I'm speaking, God instructed me. Your kings have been instructed to bless you before the end of this your fast. Two. I don't know who I'm talking to. Right now, there's so much chaos. It seems impossible. You are at the place of trying to split up. But let me tell you something. Your king that God has ordained for you. Are you hearing me? God has instructed
him. Amen.
And just as God troubled the heart of Hezekiah, King Hazarus, to favor Mordecai.
Amen.
He was troubled, and trouble could not sleep. Turned to the other side, he was seeing Mordecai in the dream. Turned to the other side, he was seeing Mordecai. Got up to go pee. Went back to bed, he was still seeing Mordecai. So what is this? Open the book of remembrance. Somebody's book of remembrance will be open this season. your husband that has left a long time ago because of this prayer, Esther prayer. Somehow we remember you. We remember you. We remember you. We remember you. He's trying to make love to a strange woman. He's seeing your face. Everywhere he's seeing your face. Everywhere tormented by your face. God is about to do something. If you believe that, shout hallelujah.
Amen. That is me.
Hallelujah.
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 Amen.
Amen. That's only shout.
Amen.
My time has come.
My time has come.
Hallelujah. Glorious God. My God. How many of you want Persephone back?
Yes.
Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Amen. He'll be coming again to come speak to us, I believe.
Hallelujah.
You know, he'll be rushing out and heading to work, you know. Hallelujah. So praise God. He spoke to us before in the past, and it was a real blessing.
Yes.
Amen. Amen. We prayed a lot together. We prayed a lot together. We fasted together. Amen. Hallelujah. I know we'll be doing a lot in the future together.
Man of God. Hallelujah. Yes.
What a God is that.
Thank you for your blessing. Thank you, Father.
Gain more knowledge for his words. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Gain more knowledge for his words.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Knowledge destroys ignorance in the name of Jesus Christ.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Yes.
Hallelujah. Time has not gone. We must pray. Somebody say we must pray.
We must pray.
Hallelujah. I love the article somebody said. They say, reading can seriously damage your ignorance.
Amen.
It can seriously damage your ignorance.
Hallelujah.
Amen. You must make sure. You must make sure. If you can read your scriptures 10 chapters a day, you'll be a genius. Amen.
Hallelujah.
You must read two books before the end of the month.
Yes.
Every month, you must read at least two books.
Yes, Lord.
Hallelujah. Glory to God.
Yes, Lord.
Okay, let's pray. Get your anointing oil. I was reading a particular scripture, and I the Lord began to speak to me. He says, I want you to do this for my people. Thank you, my Jesus. Just bear with me. Please don't focus on me. Just focus on God. Just pray. Just pray along with God. Amen. Whatever scriptures the Lord gives to you, just pray. Just pray. Amen. Hallelujah. You've received the word of the Lord today, and thank God for what he's about to do today. Glorious God. And I sing praises to your name. Oh, Lord, praises to your name. Oh, Lord, for your name is great and greatly to be praised. And I sing praises to your name. Oh, Lord, praises to your name. Oh, Lord, for your name is great and greatly to be praised. Amen. Hallelujah. 2 Kings chapter 4, verse 17. 2 Kings chapter 4, verse 17. And if you have to go, you have to go. Amen. Hallelujah. You can keep, if you are allowed to use your phone at work, you can mute your phone and just listen. Hallelujah. And the woman conceived and bare a son. And at that season that Elisha had said unto her, according to the time of life. And when the child was grown, it fell on a day that he went out to his father to the reapers. And he said unto his father, my head, my head. And he said to a lad, carry him to his mother.
my head, my head, my head, my head. How many of you are feeling that? Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
And when he had taken him, brought him to his mother, he sat on her knee till noon, then died. This guy grew up normal. One day, my head, my head. They did not rush him to the hospital. Neither did they rush him to the prophet, because they thought it was normal, was a normal attack. Where did that head come from? Where did that pin arrow come from? My head, my head. And he settled in the mother's lap and gave up the ghost. Some of us have been tormented in our head.
Yeah.
Some of us, children have been tormented on their head. And if you don't deal with that demon, it can result to suicide. If you don't deal with that demon, it can result to migraine. If you don't deal with that demon manipulation on the head, all kinds of arrows are fired into the head.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. And where is the attack coming from? Why has the enemy measured his attack on the head? Hallelujah. Genesis chapter 3, verse 15. We're about to pray. I'm telling you the fire quickly, quickly, quickly. Just go with me quickly. Time is fast, friends. Thank you, Father. Genesis 3. The Lord was showing me this morning about so much warfare. 3 verse 15. It's all about the woman. I will put enmity between thee and the woman, between thy seed and her seed. What is it talking about? God is placing a curse between the snake. Now, the snake was best friends to Eve before. Amen. It was through the snake that the devil saw the relationship. Amen. And during the snake and Eve, it was a genuine relationship. It was a godly one. It was a sweet one. But the devil saw that Eve loved snake. And the devil says, I will enter the snake as I enter Judas. And he entered the snake. Amen. Hallelujah. And so right now, God begins to say, okay, you know what? Since you have messed up the human race, I'm going to put an enmity between you and the woman. So from this moment, there will be no reconciliation. You and the woman will always hate each other. And the Lord said unto in verse 15, I will put an enmity between thee and the woman, and between thy seed and her seed, and it shall bruise thy head, and thou shalt bruise his heel. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. You can understand that that is why so many women are under severe attack, because the powers of the serpent, amen, powers of the serpent have made it that their first attack should be the woman, because it began from the beginning. Hallelujah. So every woman that wants to walk with God, amen, they have to be careful because of the hands that are laid upon their head. They are so vulnerable to attacks because of this. Let us pray. Get your anointing oil. Ali Brandon Lebon Sombahatelia. Regede Reboboko Brondo Ribia Palabaya. Jede Rebeca Brando Ribica Talabadilia. Jade Rebobo Rada Ribia Sadahaya. Hallelujah. 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 Say this after me. Say, every hand anointed to waste my head. Wither! Open your mouth and begin to pray. Wither! In the name of Jehovah. Every hand anointed to waste my head. Wither! Open your mouth and fire prayer. Ragadara baba kaba rebebia fire. Hallelujah. Please do not take this lightly. Do not take this lightly. Do not take this lightly. I was in the church and I was giving a prayer point like this. I mean, this is a true story. I was giving a prayer point like this and I was doing some serious warfare. Lay your hands to your chest. Every arrow of death fired against me, backfire. One brother was just sitting down. He didn't understand what I was saying. And he's a pastor, one of the assistant pastors. Do you know within a week, this guy was rushed to the hospital? He almost died because of the heart. The veins exploded. or the actress, he was rushed to the hospital. I was there to see him. If he had prayed, only God knows if that would have been averted. Don't sit down there and just laugh at Tiku and say, ah, it does not belong to me. It belongs to you. Even if you don't need it, your family needs it, your children need it. Amen? Hallelujah. Say this after me. Every arrow for timely death, fired it through my head. Backfire, backfire. Open your mouth and fire prayer. Ragada rebebega barababayada. Zelebrebebe rebebega gondolia. Let it backfire. Ragada mukuturia.
Every arrow fired into my head.
If you're a woman, make sure you pray this prayer. When you feel heaviness in your head, pray this prayer. If any dark invisible cover.
Any dark invisible cover on my head.
What is the cover? It's a veil. What is the cover? It's an embargo. What is the cover? It's heaviness. Every dark invisible cover. In Jesus' name, shout this loud and clear. Every manipulation of my glory.
Through my head.
If a wrong hand will touch your head, if a wrong hand breaks your head, if a wrong demonic covenanted hand touches your head while braiding your head, you are in trouble.
Yeah.
Because something will be stolen or deposited in your life. Are you hearing me?
Yes.
Confusion can be imparted into your head just by wrong hands laid on your head.
Mm-hmm.
Some of you will not allow a pastor to lay hands on your head, but you allow an unbeliever to braid your head for 3 hours.
Mm-hmm. Amen.
That's a direct fleshly carnal impartation.
Yeah.
Impartation without grace.
List
of frustration. Some of you have received impartation of anger.
Yeah,
because a woman, the last woman that braided your hair, she was very angry before she touched your head.
Wow.
And that spirit was imparted directly into you.
Oh my God.
And you came home, you gave all your children trouble. That day was thunder. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Sexual perversion has been imparted through wrong hands.
Jesus.
Amen.
Yeah.
A woman that masturbates, that day she just come out. And some of you just like all these homosexual men. Going around and trying to design your hair, and you're happy. Mess up your spirit, your destiny. From that day, perversion entered your dream. You can't even dream straight anymore. Men and women try to touch you in your dream. That error must be corrected. Say that error must be corrected. Hallelujah. Body, baby, every manipulation of my glory,
Hallelujah.
I want us to pray this prayer quickly. Just 2-3 prayers before we go. Amen. So that we can just anoint ourselves and go quickly. Time is fast spent. Please bear with me. Say this loud and clear. Say, every curse operating against my head, die by the power of the blood. Every curse operating against my head, for your head not to experience open heavens. When a man begins to lay his hands on your head, usually they will utter a curse or speak a curse over you. Every curse issued against my head, by the power of the blood, it is broken. Open your mouth and begin to pray. I terminate every curse. Rababa la bandele bondoli, regede rebebe rebebe abaya, rababa rebebe rebebe abaya, let the cross be terminated, rebebe rebebe abaya, rababa rebebe rebebe abaya, rababa rebebe rebebe abaya, mandio la bandele bondoli, regede rebebe rebebe abaya. Amen. Say this after me. Say this after me. Say chains of darkness.
Chains of darkness.
Say chains of darkness.
Chains of darkness.
Binding my head.
Break by fire.
Break by fire. Many of you remember, many of you remember the anointed oil. Hallelujah. Take your oil now. Open your oil. We prayed. I won't be praying and blessing oil today. We did that already. Amen. Hallelujah. But I want you to anoint your hands. Amen. And you're going to, with your hands, you want to anoint your forehead. I didn't mean your head on your head. I mean your forehead, your bare head. Your head, amen, hallelujah, above your eyes. Hallelujah. Your forehead. Just anoint your forehead. And I want you to say this prayer. Say, blood of Jesus. Say, water of life. Say, fire of God. Wash my head. Blood of Jesus, water of life, fire of God, wash my head. When you say wash my head, you begin to rub your hand on your forehead. You know how you rub your hand on your forehead? You don't do it once. Just keep rubbing, just keep rubbing, just keep rubbing back and forth. And you begin to feel heat on your forehead. Just keep doing it. Wash my head with the blood of Jesus. I wash my head with the water of life. I wash my head with the fire of God. Begin to go back and forth. You begin to feel heat in your hand. Just keep it on. Just keep doing it. Keep doing it. There's some mark God is erasing. There's some mark God is wiping off from your head. Just keep doing it. Keep doing it. You almost feel dizzy. God is removing from some sort of darkness, deposits, pollutions in your head. Just keep rubbing it, rubbing it. I wash my head from pollution. I wash my head with fire, with fire, with fire, with the blood of Jesus. I wash my head. Rababaka Subahata. Let
Lord, I want you to be
the father. You're going to release these three virtues on your head, and then we pray. Say this after me. Say, reign of wisdom.
Reign of wisdom.
Reign of knowledge.
Reign of knowledge.
Reign of favor.
Reign of favor.
Fall upon my head in the name of Jesus.
Fall upon my head in the name of Jesus.
Reign of wisdom.
Reign
of knowledge.
Reign of knowledge.
Reign of favor.
Reign of favor.
Fall upon my head now.
You are lifted. You are blessed. Hallelujah. Say, I am blessed.
I am blessed.
Say, this head is a good head.
This head is blessed.
This head is blessed. Henceforth, let no man trouble me.
I bear
in my body the marks of the Lord Jesus Christ.
I
receive the mind of Christ.
I receive the mind of Christ.
Well, God bless you. Amen. And thank God for everyone that has been on the prayer line. The Lord bless you. The Lord keep you. The Lord guide you.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah.
Amen.
I want to say this. Amen. Hallelujah. I want to thank God for His consistency. What did I say to you earlier? There is a miracle that God has for everyone. Listen to me. There are two particular ladies. You will testify. You will testify.
Amen.
This event runs to an end. How many of you know that I hear from God?